All right, we are live again, and for part two. So, the previous part of this was recorded before the game against Modo yesterday. You should be able to watch that on YouTube later today, Sunday. But right now, we are going to the actual playoffs versus Lexand. So, let's have a look at the standings. We ended up squeaking in seventh. Seventy-six points. And we qualified against Lulio. No, Lulio. Seventh and tenth meet, and HV71 and Lulio met as well. We knocked them out. So we are one of two teams. So we are higher seed, which means we face off against number two seed Lexant. 96 points. Score quite a few goals per game. 308, 2.54 per game goals against. Not a great power play. But I mean, most power plays are not that great in the simulation. The best one is Lulio, 21.2%. We have pretty decent penalty kill, that's for sure. Right. And the playoff tree, obviously, Elbrio won against Hover, so they are the other team from the play-in. So quarterfinals. Now, Skellefteå has already won the first game. Elbrio has already won the first game versus Timrå. So let's see how our first game goes. Decent amount of shots from both sides, but no goals so far. And no goals when we end the first period. Max Verano scores to make it a 1-0 game. Joachim Ryan scores, make it a 1-1 game just before the end of the second period, and we have a 1-1 game going into third. And Carter Ashton scores, make it a 2-1 game. Let's hop in here, try to make it a 2-2 scoreline. Problem is, I don't really think we have the fire. We
We
have
are
the
now in the
firepower
back
to
half
get
of period
through to
number
a 2-2
three.
game.
Welcome
We'll
to those
see.
viewers just joining us and tuning in right now. Lexens continuing to hold a 2-1 lead. And now it's grabbed by Larson. Along the half wall with the puck. That's blocked in front. And a nice save there as play continues.
It's amazing to me how he always looks like he's in the right position because he tracks and reads the play so well. And this time he gets in front of the puck that's right in the middle of the ice as the shooter's got a dangerous opportunity.
Comes up with the block. Oh, somehow he gets a sliver of it and keeps him at bay.
Well, this save is all about the compete to find the puck. I mean, it's a battle, and you're trying to battle your opponent. You can see him bobbing up and down, trying to find the puck. He finds it at the last minute, reacts, and makes the save.
Good defensive effort to poke it away. Lexan's got a hold of the puck. Exploring options here inside the defensive zone. And he loses possession after a solid looking for space inside the D zone. Carlson's got it against the boards. In close! Blocked in traffic. Moves the puck into the attacking area. Takes a shot. Blocked in traffic. Let's Sands get a hold of it along the wall. Takes the feed. Hooked away in the neutral zone. Let's Sands regain possession of the puck. Carlson's got it in the offensive zone. The Redhawks take over on possession. Couldn't catch up to that pass. And they'll keep on playing as icing is waved off. Takes it into the slot. And the traffic jam in front blocks the shot. Great reflex on display tonight on his part.
Armalis has been great tonight, James. I mean, he's been underseas, really peppered in his own zone, but he's finding the puck. He's out battling his opponent, and it's a reason it's a tight game.
Ah. Well, that sucked. Okay. Too little time. I jumped in too late. Okay. So, 2-1 loss in the first one. It's not a biggie. I have to make sure to at least win one of the two here, hopefully. Again, no goals in the first period. No goals after two periods. Okay, let's play the whole whole third period this time.
It's away from puck drop for period number three. A perfect time for those viewers just joining us here tonight, and we are still scoreless. Puck grab by Ryan. Knocked away by Patrick. Sends a pass over. From along the boards, moves the puck ahead. I don't think anybody was hanging onto the puck after that hit. Quick pass across to Patrick. Malmo's got control of it now here in the offensive end. Gets it to the other point. Oh, Riddick! Perfect!
There's nobody there, though. Literally, nobody is in front of net. Oh, what a goal. What a goal.
And finally, we have one in this game.
Yeah, it took a while, James, but they found the back of the net, and it's still the first one in the game, so the opponent is hunting.
The Redhawks, with that goal, have gone up by
one here in the third.
Well, you're better up by one than down by one, James, but there's a lot of runway left. Now it's a mindset of attack, but be defensively responsible.
Slides it across to Lang. Can't get a hold of that pass. Lang's got it along the wing. Here's an opportunity to clear the zone. Knocked down at the blue line.
That's an icing call, isn't it? Yep.
Icing, icing is call. The call. We'll get a face up at the other end.
Here's the change.
Cheryl, it looks like there's a real strategy to shorten the bench. Do you like this time of the game here to do this?
Well, I do, James. I mean, you're trailing by one. You got to find a way to create some momentum. What better course to take than get your top players out there more often?
Too many bodies in the way. Lexan's got the puck in the defensive end. Moves it to Forsberg. Moves the puck. Tries to feed it over.
Ah, I thought. Oh.
And that's just out of reach. Ashton's tripped up.
No.
Is in the air, signaling penalty.
Important task for the key players ahead of them, up by one, and a real opportunity to protect it.
And they'll start the possession.
There we go.
And they'll get it out of the defensive end. Lexan's got the puck behind the net. Through pass ahead. Good hit to bump him off the puck. The Redhawks have it now. Here's a short pass to Ryan. And he's ridden off the puck. Quick pass to Verano. Lexan's got the puck in their own end. Lexan's got it along the wall. Grabbed along the board by Lindholm. Lexan's got possession here in the offensive zone. Moves it quickly over to Verano. Handles the puck. Oh, what an effort as he lays out for the block. Here's a race for the loose puck. Lexan's gained possession along the boards. Perreault's got the puck in his own zone.
Pihalny's penalty is almost expired.
Ducks it in. The Redhawks gain control of the puck against the wall. And he takes the dish.
Ooh.
Lexan's got the puck now. Takes the feed. Slides it over to Padeno. The Redhawks gain possession.
Malmo staring down a shutout late in the game. You know they're going to do the best to protect their goaltender to ensure that they get it. But at the end of the day, it's about bragging rights. Listen, the other team isn't able to score. They're not able to penetrate the inside of the ice and cash in. You're feeling it, you love it, and you're going to share it.
We want a second goal here, so we're going to push it for it.
1-0 is where we sit at this point.
We need to cycle the puck a little bit more, move the puck quicker.
Lexan's got a hold of the puck.
And win some faceoffs maybe, that would be nice.
They're trying to maintain possession inside the defensive zone. The Redhawks play along the boards. Takes the feed at the point.
Yeah.
And we play on. Lexan's Achilles heel tonight has been finding offense as they trail here in the third. And after the draw at center, they've got a hold of the puck. Lexan's got it in the red zone. Takes control of the puck. Covers up the puck and will get a whistle.
Well, he's had an excellent night, James, and he's been reading the flow phenomenally, and that's exactly. right there and be able to hold on.
Centers glide into the dot as a faceoff.
Let's see if we can win the faceoff here.
Back underway.
There we go.
Feed to Kivaholme. And he takes the feed. Slides it over with pace to Lindholm. Handles the pass. Toss it up on the play. Lexan's looking to break out of the road in. And a delay.
I'm poking the puck. When I'm pushing the button, I'm poking the puck. But
now the PK unit, they got to get out there and they got to do a job.
They'll go back to work on their special teams.
Yeah, whatever.
Well, they earned this a power play, James, through hard work, and it's an opportunity even the score here. They need to find a way to execute and get back to the lead score.
Tries to get it out of the zone. Oh, and they need that getting the puck out.
That's a great defensive play at this time of the game, James. Listen, when it's not in your zone, they can't score. That's the best play in my mind at this time.
And now he moves it quickly to Alvarez. Unable to reach that one. Patrick's picking up steam.
Nolan Patrick, really?
Oh, excellent use of the stick as he knocks that one away. We got a stoppage. Let's get the call.
Okay.
We almost hear the guys as that third penalty within the frame has been called here, James. A tough position if they can't get any rhythm going on their bench.
And from off the wing, he comes up with it, with both centers scrummed up. Gets it out of his own end. Grabs the puck and moves on out here with this man advantage. Slides it diagonally to Patrick. Slick feed.
Yeah, see, that's interference on their guy. He's blocking my way to try to defend. Seriously.
Save.
We're going to OT, I guess.
A critical draw here.
It's very unfortunate.
The Redhawks win the faceoff.
Big save right there.
You
know what? Let's try it.
Top of it to get a stoppage in play. Officials call for the timeout. This is going to allow everyone to catch their collective breaths and try to come up with a strategy down the stretch here. The Redhawks win that offensive zone faceoff. And that goes off his blocker. Battling for the puck, but still hangs on. Here's a chance, sends it in front. And that goes off the body and arrive.
Yeah, because they always have the stick perfectly to block the pass. Okay.
We go to sudden death. Overtime is coming up. Are you hashtagging overtime challenge on social media? Because they're ready to get it underway. Overtime is underway here. Let's go, Lions. Let's go. Lindholm's going to play against the half wall. Oh, it is off the outside of the post. The adrenaline's rushing. You're getting yourself to the right spot at the right time with an opportunity to go ahead in the game and hit the post in it.
Carries it across the line. Here's a pass down low.
The Redhawks looking against the half wall.
How does that not go in? There's a little bit of a gap there, but somehow he stops it with the stick. I don't know. I don't feel like that is all that realistic. And again.
A spirited battle along the boards for the puck. Getting a little too physical to maintain possession. Puck picked up by Ryan. Moved up ahead here in the neutral zone. Oh, what a stop! Yes! He denies him with a monstrous save here in overtime! Both teams are set. They're ready to drop.
Let's go even more aggressive. I mean, why not?
And a solid job tying up his opponent.
Everything to win, nothing to lose here, right? There you go. 2-1 OT winner and 1-1 in the series. Let's go. Anything can happen in the playoffs. Third game, first game in Malmo. Let's see how we do on home ice. Pretty much dominating the shots. Doesn't mean much if you don't score, as we know from the Moto game yesterday. 13-7, but no goals. Alright. Second period. No goals also in the second. Badinka scores. Wow, okay. And then Verano scores, so it's a 1-1 game. If we go to overtime, I'm going to hop in. Just play to overtime. Are we going to overtime here again? Yep, it's a 1-1 game.
We are just about to drop the puck here in overtime. What a time for you to tune in if you're just joining us here now. The next goal will be a golden goal. We are all tied and it is sudden death. Melrose on the attack. Loses his balance on the play. Leksand's got the puck. The Redhawks gain control of it. And a good use of the body to knock the puck loose.
Ah,
down on his bottom hand and just sent that one over the top bar.
Quick pass to Verano. Melmo's got a hold of the puck now. From off the boards, he sends it into the open ice. And that banks off a stick. Works it across to Verano. Leksand's looking to break out. From the defensive zone, they move the puck around. Moves it quickly over to Lindholm. Grabs the puck. Here they come inside the neutral zone. Takes the pass. Shot! And they got caught up in traffic and hits a stick. And the puck's not loose.
Amazing how he was able to poke the puck away without taking away my skates, right? Von Bonnikov.
Red Hawk.
take advantage of the overtime power play. Right.
Well, James, I'm not sure if the emotion got the better of them with that power play unit, but it's overtime. You got to find a way to be urgent, drive the paint. That was not acceptable.
Lexens won the draw, and they take possession here in the open ice. Steps into the offensive end. Malmo's got the puck along the boards.
Kivialma.
The Redhawks take it along the wall. Knocked off the puck. Lexens got control of it now to the road end. Grabs the puck in the defensive zone.
Close.
Looking dangerous as they move along the boards.
Nope.
Fires it into the offensive zone. And now he angles it across to Forsberg. Fires it! Makes the puck stop! And they'll cover it up, forcing a stoppage in play. This is a face-off. They'll definitely want to win here inside the offensive zone. Malmo's won the draw, and they'll go to work. Puts it on net, and it goes off a stick. Lexan's got a hold of it against the wall. And sends it just out of reach. Quick pass to Olsen. Moves the puck. The Redhawks have it against the wall. Chance in front. What a chance, but that goes off target off a body in front. Lexan's got it in their own zone. Tries to feed it across. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Sends the pass down low. And a poke check knocks the puck away. Referee's hand goes up in the air.
So when they stick lift, it's clean. But when I try to stick lift, I'm next to the player and I'm stick lifting. It's automatically a slashing. Got it.
On the offensive attack now. Here comes the official's decision.
So frustrating to take a penalty in overtime with the game.
I mean, at least it's accurate, right?
Lexan
getting a preferable treatment. It's nothing new. Big save. So when you have three players on you, nothing happens when you're being physical. Got it. Alright, we got about a minute in power play.
The Redhawks gain possession along the wall. Through the neutral zone, moving the puck along the side. The Redhawks carry it along the wall.
Oh, I lost the puck after the deke. Oh my god! What is this?
The Redhawks don't like it, but they'll serve two in the penalty box. Batten down the hatches, they should open up here with a little 4-on-4 on the ice.
Not typically that we see 4-on-4 action, although it's a lot of fun. You certainly know they practice it in practice. This is something that they're aware of, they know what they're doing, they want to possess the puck and try and create numerical advantage.
Yeah, that's a bad pass, and they'll be forced to do this over again. Their man's now out of the box, and they'll take advantage on the power play. More time off the clock as they grab the puck. Hard hit frees up the
puck. Picked up along the boards by Patrick. Oh,
over the boards, and look where he lands!
Oh, man, he's in the laps of his opponent, and it's easier said than done to get
close to win it, and he denies him with a monstrous save here in overtime! Moves it to Korkkonen.
What is going on here defensively? Why did my player stop?
Leksand's power play fails to capitalize an OT.
That's a deflating one, James. Power play in overtime and you don't execute. You can see the bench right now. They were standing, now they're all sitting.
A lot on the line here in this offensive zone faceoff. And they take possession after the defensive zone faceoff.
You hate it when you ice the puck and it comes 200 feet back to your zone. You gotta give your center a tap on the pads after you win that one and get out.
There's an injection of energy with that hit. They gain the offensive zone from the middle. Jostled off the puck. Here's a short pass to Handebar. From the point, looks to make something happen.
Oh,
and
my
that
God.
Makes a move in front. The Red Hawks look to start the transition game. Leksand gain possession along the boards. Picks off the pass in the defensive zone.
Why didn't the defenseman change?
Slides it back to the blue line. Easy pass in. A chance to get it out of the defensive zone.
That is just fucking stupid, isn't it?
We will continue to play on. Sudden Death continues here on EA Sports. And we are just moments away from overtime. Overtime rolls on. The next one is the game winner here. Leksand's got the puck against the boards. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Ryan. And we got a delayed penalty coming up here. There's the whistle, and here's the call.
Well, the coach didn't feel this was warranted. It wasn't egregious enough during overtime to call it, but it is a penalty. This is an urgent kill.
Leksand's won the draw. Looking to bring the defensive zone. Tipped in at the line. Great heads up play, and the power play continues.
Yeah, and frustrating for the PK unit. You get that puck on your stick, you got to be hard and heavy on it. Quick release and find the open ice to get the clear, James. That's unacceptable.
Handles the puck. Person's got it against the boards. A chance for the win.
Korkkonen in the slot. Always a win. Finally. Jesus, we got a bounce. Okay. Whew. Two overtime wins. Let's go. Matt Cato scores the first here. Nolan Patrick. I wonder if there's a way to turn off trades completely where you can't sign free agents, because that is just cheating. Okay, we're down 2-0. I'm just gonna call it. This is gonna be a loss. We're not going to be able to get back into this game, right? It's going to be a 3-0 win for Leksand, probably. There you go. 3-0 one. Oh, we score. Too little, too late. 3-1 win. Vademus scores twice in 11 seconds. Okay. Lassen scores to make it a 1-2 game. Let's see if we can get back. Filian Bombonikov scores to make it a 2-2 game. Okay, so it's a little bit more open now. It's a little bit more open. See. Can get a winner, and it's another overtime.
Right. We are just about to start period number three. For those of you just joining us, perfect timing here tonight, and we are all tied up at 2 goals apiece. Quick pass to Corrigan, and a good heads up defensive play.
Let's go.
Wow, and this has been trending to happen, James. It is holding on the puck with the sense.
Bounced off the back wall and in.
Malmo's got to feel like they've got some extra energy now with that 1-goal lead here in the third.
Well, you can see the finish line, but you're not there yet. So you got to make sure that you continue to press, James. You got to close quickly on your opponent when they have the puck. Don't give them an inch in all three zones.
Lipson's got the puck here in the open ice. Great positioning by the defender. At center ice now, he grabs the puck. And that goes off a player. And he takes the dish. And the puck skips out of the zone, they'll have to regroup. And now it's grabbed by Johansson. Lexan's got a hold of the puck.
Tonight makes a good decision to hold on to this one.
Lexan's gonna start with the puck at their own end. Along the side, here they come through the neutral zone. Chase that pass back to the point. Came up with a nice save.
Reaction time is everything when you're a goaltender, and that's what you see from a young age. Been working on all of those different drills to help them with these kinds of saves. Just flash the leather and make the save. What a glove hand. Bademo's go-to guy in this game, multiple points so far.
The Redhawks gain control of the puck against the wall. Battle along the boards. Quick feed to Olsen. Breaks the ball off the post.
Marvel's been working hard in the quick field to show how they threw up this entire game, and the reason they have the lead, they wanted to extend their cushion, but unfortunately, that good positioning by the goaltender, but nonetheless, it goes off the post and out.
Lexan's got the puck along the wall. Great heads up play with the stick by Kivaholmi. Rocks it on the play. Great read with the stick.
Make a change.
Armella steals one with that incredible save, James, and his team knows it. You can see him puff out his chest. He's playing a little bit of swagger now. And everyone in front of him knows that they got to energize. They got to elevate their game.
Melrose got the puck against the board. Deflected away. Nice defensive use of the stick there. The Red Hawks going to work on offense. Oh, smart heads up play to put that one away. Motion to the hallway.
James, I mean, the shooter's in the middle of the ice, he's in the slot area. He's got to get to the top of the crease, square to the puck to be able to make that save. Great job.
There's the whistle as the puck is outside. Nearing the midway mark of the period, the Red Hawks are giving their fans something to cheer about as they lead it 3-2. Malmo's going to start off with the puck here in the neutral zone after winning that faceoff. Lost momentum as the puck leaves the zone. Passed up ahead. Takes the pass into the middle of the neutral zone. And a stick in the lane ends that threat. Tries to get the puck over to Lindholm.
This is the best part of the game. It's really tight. It's down the stretch. One mistake either way will be the difference maker.
Lugs the puck into the corner of the offensive zone. Great reach with the poke check. And the puck's kick free. Sends it ahead to Olsen. And he loses control of the puck. Oh, and a misfire as that goes right out of the zone. Puck picked up by Johansson. Leksand's looking to break out. From the neutral zone now. Here's a pass in front. And that's off target. Puck grabbed by Carlson. Huge steal in his own end. Here's a short pass to Korkkonen. Shot! Can't get it to go. Picks up the puck. Here's a shot! Can't connect as it goes off a stick. Handles the puck at the point. Here's a shot. Swats at it with the glove and got just enough of it. Grabbed along the board by Carlson. Puck is picked up here in the neutral ice by Larson. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Malmo's got a hold of the puck now. And he takes the feed. Taken by Kukkonen. And that's intercepted in the defensive end. And that's deflected. Handles the pass. The Red Hawks gain the zone. Along the half wall with the puck. Comes up with the stop. Looks to stop. From one point man to another.
Padinka scores. I don't know how that got in, but
James, I mean, their opponent does not have an answer. They were absolutely stunned. I mean, they are like a freight train just pounding down on them.
How did it go in?
This is exactly why you send bodies to the front of the
shot,
net, James. You
want
to create a screen, and the goaltender drops into the butterfly position as a DP battling to find the puck. Can't find
he saves it with the stick. It goes bar, back, and in. Jeez, okay.
Here in the late goings of the period.
Well, you
the
know,
Red Hawks have all the
what are those
right
weird
now,
goals? But yeah, we can relax a little bit now. Because we got some very good pressure there and scored.
Draw here. Patrick's won the faceoff. Slides the puck over. And someone's going off here as the ref's hand goes high in the air. The Red Hawks are going to be short-handed, tripping the
right
call.
Let's see.
Big opportunity on the power play here.
first power play opportunity of the game. You know they've worked on this in practice, the setup, the look that they want. Let's see how they move the puck around the perimeter and look to attack.
The Redhawks move the puck into the defensive zone. Lexan's got possession of the puck. Puck scooped up by Verano. Sends it in front. Oh, it comes up with a stop. Trying to clear. Oh, that's a big time clear there.
The critical juncture of the game, and you're in your own zone. You got to find a way to get that puck out, and you do it. You focused on the details, and you made sure you got it.
The Redhawks get a hold of the puck along the boards. Lexan's got possession here in the offensive zone. And offside, we'll get a reset here. Still some precious time left on this power play as they get set to drop the puck.
Okay, one right here.
The Redhawks win it. Here's a chance to clear the puck from his own end. And that's just out of reach. Lexan's got a hold of it along the wall. Brings the puck into the offensive end now. Moves into the slot. And that ricochets off a twig in front.
10 seconds left.
Lexan's got the puck along the boards. Through center. And the power play unit comes up empty on that one.
That's a great job by the PK unit, James. Late in the game, when they're up by one, and they close and shut it down. Awesome job by everyone to figure out how to get it down the ice and kill some valuable seconds.
Here in the later stages of this period, we've got ourselves a 4-2 hockey game. Coming up on the final minute of regulation time. Kick it along the wall by Patrick. And he moves the puck back inside his own end. They gain possession here inside the neutral zone. They fight for it along the boards. Lexan's got the puck. And now he tries to get it across to Lang. Great use of the body to knock him off the puck. Lexan's trying to make something happen in the offensive zone. And he came up with a solid stop on that play.
Werner's had a solid night between the pipes, James. I mean, he's done everything he could to stop the puck, as indicated by his save percentage. But his team has also been really strong. Got the confidence of their netminder, and they've created a ton of opportunities.
There's the final horn sounding, putting this baby to rest. A series.
All right, so we need one more win. We can win at home in game six. Oh, Patrick scores right away. Quine scores. Nice. About fucking time. So it's a 1-1 game going into the second. It's completely even in shots as well. Called pass on scores to make it a 2-1 game. And Kokkonen scores to make it a 3-1 game. So we are clearly taking the lead here and taking a handle on things. Nolan Patrick scores again. Make it a 2-3 game going into third. Do we get a defensively solid game here? Okay. 3-2 win. We move on to the semis. Vidan von Bonnikov has unfortunately been injured. What options do we have on the forwards? We have Philip Sitar, we have Albert Sjöberg, Freddy Larsson. I liked his game yesterday versus Modo. He was really intense to play against. I think I'm going to give him a chance here. I'm going to move up. I'm going to replace him like that. I'm going to move up Alvarez. There we go. Who do we face? We face Skellefteå. Not our favorite opponent. Okay. So the semifinals are the semifinals are Växjö versus Örebro and Skellefteå versus Malmö. Pretty crazy that it could be I will most likely lose this series to Skellefteå, and Växjö will most likely win versus Örebro. Then it would be a repeat of last year's final in real life. That is pretty awesome. So no goals so far. And still no goals. I'm just gonna finish the game and see what we get. Boom, 3-1. Okay. All right, they score all the goals that are scored in the third period. 3-1 scoreline. I'm probably gonna lose four straight here. Maybe. Two goals. One goal each. Oh, we turned it around in the third. Jesus. 4-3 win. Let's go. Alright. I kind of do want a repeat of the last year's finals just to see what the game thinks. Who the game thinks is the better team. Like when it's AI versus AI, you know? Zero, zero, 1-1, 1-1, 2-1 game, okay. It makes sense. I'm not trying to be defeatist here, but Skellefteå is a better, much better team than we are. In 9 times out of 10, they should be winning. Kokkonen scores on the power play, okay, nice. So that's a 1-0 game, 1-1 game, 2-1 win, okay. So this is going to be a little bit more even than we first thought, I guess. Växjö have won 4 straight, okay, so there you go. Växjö is absolutely steamrolling their opponent. Pär Lindholm scores, Alan Quine scores. Anton Olsson scores. And then they score again, and then an empty net goal there for a 4-1 win. So Skellefteå leads 3-2. I guess they win in 6 or in 7. I don't know. We'll have to see here. I'll make sure to play this one so that we can have a 7th. I think I think Malmo, even though Malmo is a weaker team than most teams in the playoffs, we could definitely push any team to 7 games. That's how close this league is. Like, even in real life, that is how close it is. Like, it very small margins, very little difference between the teams. This is a 1-1 game now, by the way. And Paioniemi scores as well to make it a 2-1 game. And that's a 2-2 game. And they win 3-2. Okay. All right. We're gonna have a repeat. We're gonna have a repeat. Let's see who wins between Växjö and Skellefteå. Are they going to steamroll Skellefteå? Nope. 2-1 game. 2-1 series, sorry. 2-2 series. Ooh, Skellefteå takes the series lead. Växjö equalize, so this is a seventh decider. And Växjö wins. Oh my god, that is accurate. Okay. I mean, if this happens in real life, I would sort of take it. I would hope that Växjö would lose for once, but semifinals, losing to Skellefteå in 6 games, it wouldn't be so bad considering where we've been all year, really. Right, well, there you have it. There you have it. This is the playoff tree. All right. Thank you so much for watching, and have a good rest of your weekend. Bye for now.